Hey, what's good with y'all boys, man? We back with another video. Before I get into this video, make sure you leave a... Didn't I say I was going to stop doing that? Man, subscribe if you're new and join the TJY game, man. So, hey, check this out, bro. Listen, the reason why I want to stop doing it, bro, because it's like, bro, y'all didn't even watch the video yet, but I'm coming on this bitch talking about some leave a like, bro. I guess it was just my intro. Bro, let me know should I keep that intro, bro, because listen, I might change that shit. You know what I'm saying? But hey, man, we got Lil Dicky today, man. We got Lil Dicky, a professional rapper. Now, this has been requested, highly requested, like many times. You get what I'm saying? I just now getting around to this shit. You know what I'm saying? So, for all y'all Lil Dicky supporters over here going crazy, you know what I mean? Hey, listen, I know y'all Lil Dicky supporters, but hey, is y'all part of the TJY gang, though? Because if y'all part of the TJY gang, man, leave hashtag TJY in the comment section, bro. You know what I mean? Because I know y'all rock with Lil Dicky, bro, but do y'all rock with TJY gang? You know what I'm saying? So, leave it in the comment section, man. We're going to get right into this video. Lil Dicky, professional rapper. For those of y'all boys that don't know, I rock with Lil Dicky. I think he tough. I think he probably one of the best lyricists that I've seen in a while. He do his thing, bro. You know what I'm saying? He do his thing. I like his style. I like the fact that he be himself. I think he lit, bro. You know what I'm saying? I think he lit. So let's get right into this video, bro.
Hello, how can I help you?
Hi, my name's Dave Bird. I have an appointment today. It's probably under Lil Dicky, actually. I'm a rapper, so.
Okay, and who are you here to see?
Snoop Dogg, says here, Snoop D-O-G-G.
Oh yeah, he's right down the hall. First door to your right. Give him a knock and he should be right with you.
Grab a seat.
Thanks, I'm Dave. Very nice to meet.
Dave, what it do? You can call me dog. Let me just check your sheet.
No problem, sir. Let me just say, I'm a big fan of the shit that y'all made. I can't lie, I've been thinking about this all day.
All good, there's a reason that we call Dave. Let me start with your background, where you come from.
Sure, I was undergrad down there in Richmond.
Before that.
Are you talking about my hometown?
Yeah.
I was born out of Philly, grew up in a little silly old town called Cheltenham. It's in the suburbs, upper middle wealth around.
So real shit, you ain't never had to struggle for much?
I wouldn't say it like that. We just had a different kind of trap.
Elaborate.
Well, I ain't never had a tool, but I had to be the man of school, like I was doing shit I had to do. So when I finished undergrad, I'm cool and I could get whatever job I wanted.
But the job you wanted wasn't all that bumping.
Yeah, and I saw quick all the flaws that be coming when you grow up like that. When you've been racing them rats, you ain't been making them raps.
Boo-hoo, what a hardship. How you pay to get the rap shit started?
Man, my bar mitzvah money, but don't diss me, buddy. I wasn't one of them youngins.
So I guess Lil Dicky came up from, like, I guess he pretty much had the normal life type shit, but he went to rapping. Okay. Okay, that's word up. But you see how he just walked into Snoop office and shit, and my nigga got his fucking button up shirt with the tie and shit. Nigga look like he about to walk into an interview or some shit. And Snoop Dogg the interview. Listen, if Snoop Dogg called me, I'm walking in that bitch just like this. You know what I'm saying? Just like this. I'm walking in there straight like this. Like, yo, what's good, Snoop? What's popping? Listen, I ain't throwing no tie and shirt on. You know what I'm saying? But let's get back into this video.
Up on the block, who had nothing to lose. I must have wanted this a lot. I had something to choose.
Look at that. I can see there's something to prove up in your ass.
Yeah, I guess.
That's enough of the past. What makes you wanna do rap?
Oh my God, it's the best. Bitches let me drop on their breasts. Literally, I can reinvent myself. I get a form to project myself. It's never boring. Every morning, I wake up and try to best myself. I never gotta be suppressed or stealthy to express myself. It's kinda healthy.
Cool, now let me put you through a couple hypotheticals.
Sure.
In a club and a couple niggas threaten you.
I wouldn't do shit. And I don't even get what they gotta do with this.
Shut the fuck up. Rap's like life. If you wanna do this, then you won't get far. Like a little bitch.
Nah, that's my niche. Don't get offended by this. But that's the market y'all miss. That's the target I'll hit. And that's the heart of my pitch. I wanna do this whole thing different.
The fuck you mean you wanna do the whole thing?
You wanna do the whole thing different. You get what I'm saying? That's the market that he pretty much niching. It ain't about being a tough guy. You know what I'm saying? And I stand for the same thing. It ain't about being a tough guy. You know what I'm saying? Now I'm not gonna for me. I stand for the fact of, you know, be yourself. I've always stood for that. For those of y'all boys that started me watching me from day one, y'all know I stand for being yourself, bro. It ain't about being a tough guy, bro. Listen, being a tough guy just started literally 9 years ago, my nigga. Yo, drill music, bro, do you not know, bro, back in the 90s and the 80s? See, I wasn't born in the 90s and 80s, my nigga, but I just know. I'm saying? 90s and 80s, niggas was making love music, bro. Do you not understand that? Like, yo, niggas was not on this drilling shit, bro. It ain't about that shit, bro. You know what I'm saying? If you're not really living that life, why the fuck are you acting like you is? You know what I'm saying? Bro, just be yourself, bro. Stand up for who you is, my nigga. If you, listen, if you play World of Warcraft, my nigga, you play World of Warcraft. Get friends that play World of Warcraft. And when you, and when people ask you what you like to do, say you play World of Warcraft, my nigga. Don't be like, nigga, I do this and do that, my nigga. Say you play World of Warcraft. My nigga, if you like Sims, my nigga, play Sims. You know what I'm saying? Be yourself, bro, regardless. I'm telling you. Just by you being yourself, bro, yo, you. I know it's kind of scary. But you putting yourself out there, man, you might get the right attraction. You know what I'm saying? People might, you might get the right people in your life. Never know. Just be yourself, bro.
You know, I think, like, you know, traditionally people have been doing the job, you know, the same kind of way for a long time.
But traditionally speaking, this shit works, right?
No, I get that, but I just think, like, you know, you don't know if it could be working even better. And I think you should look at me as an opportunity to find that out.
So what are your biggest strengths?
Well, my flow is crazy. I can switch that amazing. For example, I could be like, ain't nobody fucking with Lil Dicky when he get up on this shit and spit his nigga ridiculous. Ribbing this shit like it's never been did, and the rhythm is never predictable, cause I can switch and deliver this shit in whatever cadence you bitches prefer.
Alright, I get it.
Top of that, lyrically, I'm pretty damn clever.
Go.
Got a long bottom bitch, called a hoe never.
Bro.
And I blew it from the junk, Derrick Rose knee.
Oh.
You can say I'm pretty smart, how I know better. And y'all been winning like Vistorius, it's no feat. Bro, I could go on and on, I'm taking over and they mad like father-in-laws.
Okay, enough of the punchline. That ain't showing me you different than the other guys.
Well, I don't know if they can run it like that, but ain't nobody else doing funny tight rap.
What's that?
Well, I could tell a story about my morning watching Boy Meets World and jerking off to the pen.
See, that's what I'm saying. You know what I'm saying? Hey, listen, for those of y'all that boys that be telling me to rewind this shit, like to catch back on that shit, I got y'all boys. You know what I'm saying? I got y'all. I just got to get the program going. Just give me like a day or two. I'm still running off my same program, so I can't really rewind the shit. But listen, I'm going to rewind, bro, and I'm going to get that shit popping. Just give me like a day or two and we're going to be straight. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, bro, that's his niche. That's his niche. And it also was going for the fact of, bro, my phone is ringing, bro. You know what I'm saying, bro? Listen, bro. Listen, I'm going to give y'all quick advice, my nigga. Never buy a house phone, my nigga. Stay with your cell phones. Never buy a house phone because it ain't no point. It ain't none. It is what it is. I'm trying to wait till the fucking house phone. Okay, it's done. All right. But pretty much what I want to let y'all boys know is that Lil Dicky, he stayed with the right niche, bro. He stand for who he is. And Snoop Dogg was like, yo, what separates you from the rest of the other rappers? You know what I'm saying? What separates you from the rest of the other rappers? It's the fact that he can storytell and he can put like funny type of shit in his raps. And he's a lyricist and he can switch his flows up really good. Just that simple.
Pangalorm, it's like the 14-year-old of Panga.
Oh, this shit like a joke to you, I don't get it.
Nah, it ain't like that. I just happen to be a nutty, abundantly funny type of individual. Like as a guy, so when I get up on the mic, I ain't finna just lie. Real recognize real, right?
Yeah, I guess. So what you trying to do 5 years from now? Tell me about the dude.
Well, I don't care about the money. Like it's the respect that I'm wanting. Honestly, I just wanna be one of the greats. Where they gotta bring a poya up every debate. I don't wanna lead the game the same.
In a nutshell, what's your legacy?
Well, I wanna be the dude that came in and made a stand-up rap. With the random rap and a man like that. For the people that was anti-rap, you're the fans of rap started to recognize the anti-rap is ironically one of the real brands of rap left.
That shit sound pretty damn complex.
I guess I want to be the best, I just want to do it my way and turn a whole game sideways and show people you ain't gotta be resigned to the highway. You can make a path while these motherfuckers drive straight.
I ain't mad at that.
Well, thanks, man, that's my plan of attack. Just let me in and I'ma rap the plaques, and I ain't about to win them back to back. I'm about to win them like it's back to back to back to back to back till I stop rapping.
You ain't even sold a damn album yet,
true.
That's a lot of talk from a Wally bet, let alone a young book, nigga.
You misread me.
No, this ain't a book, nigga.
Well, that's one of my flaws. I'm too competitive, dog.
No, you just fucking repetitive, dog. I get it, you trying to be better than all, but you aren't shit until Jenna's involved.
I get that, I gotta prove myself.
No shit, you ain't done shit.
But think about that, dog. Only doing this a couple of years, one taping them like this.
This shit is alright for your first shit, but you don't know if it's your worst shit.
Well, you don't think finding out will be worth it?
It might be, it might not, but I'ma put your ass to work, kid.
Wait, like,
my nigga Snoop is shitting on this nigga, bro. Goddamn, Snoop, chill. My nigga, you shitting all over my man Dream, bro. God damn, I understand you trying to be like, listen, you gotta get your raps up. But damn, my nigga Snoop shitting on you like, hey, listen, your shit ain't popping like that. You gotta work, which he telling him the right thing. You know what I'm saying? But damn, bro, let up on the nigga. God damn, shitting all over my man's.
Like I have the job, like really?
Well, one more thing. Let me see if you can put a hook together. What would you do for the hook for this song?
You want me to make a hook up right now?
Do I look like the type of nigga that like repeating himself?
Okay.
Man, do the hook.
I'm about to be professional. Homie, I'm professional. Maybe like a low voice type thing?
Nigga, that shit is garbage, man.
Well, you know, I feel like there might have been some upside to it, but I'm not good at thinking of things on the spot like that. Don't y'all normally, like, outsource for that kind of thing sometimes?
Whatever, man. You trying to smoke a blunt?
Right now?
Yeah.
Sure.
Dope. Juanita, bring some weed in here, please. Thank you.
You got it, Snoop. I'll be right there.
Thanks, Juanita. Super nice woman.
Nigga, why does everything you say sound so soft?
I really don't want to be spoken to like that, so.
Bro, Snoop, why is you shitting on my nigga right now? You know what I'm saying? Listen, let my nigga do him. Goddamn, you shitting all over my man's, bro. My nigga, listen, he chilling. Damn, bro. Hey, listen, everybody ain't no G like you, Snoop. Fuck.
Hey, I got y'all weed.
Damn, that's some great-looking weed. It's just so early.
Can I get you guys anything else while I'm here? Coffee, tea, head, bottled water?
Did you just say head?
Yeah. You ain't never got no head before?
I mean...
That bitch said head. Listen, you know that bitch a freak bitch. You know what I'm saying? Listen, she trying to... Listen. You know what I'm saying? She big as shit. You know what I'm saying? Listen. A quick note for y'all boys. Listen, the big girls give the best top, bro. I'm telling you. You get the big girls, nigga, they give you straight. They give you the Mega 3000, bro. I'm telling you. With the twisted hand shit. I'm telling you. You know what I'm saying? She give you the twisted hand shit. Listen, she got... Bro. Bro, you think I... Listen, some of y'all know. Don't even front me. Some of y'all know, because some of y'all niggas got hair by big girls, so don't even front me.
It just feels like a lot right now.
Okay.
But what kind of tea do you guys have?
We got mint, raspberry, Earl Grey, English breakfast.
Actually, I'll take head.
I knew your little dirty ass wanted some head.
Oh, hell nah, bro. Oh, hell nah. He talks about, okay, I'll take it. That was crazy. But I fuck with this shit. This shit was funny, bro. You know what I'm saying? This shit was funny. I fuck with Lil Dicky, bro. You know what I'm saying? I fuck with Lil Dicky. I think he lit, bro. I think he got, as far as lyrics go, he one of the best at the shit. And definitely storytelling. He one of the top as far as storytelling when it comes to this rap shit, for sure. But I drop reaction videos every single day, man, so just be on the lookout, man. Listen, for those of y'all boys that don't know, man, we just hit 1K, you know what I'm saying? We just hit 1K. Well, actually, when I'm recording this video, we haven't even hit 1K yet. But when I drop the video, and I'm going to drop a entertainment video to let y'all boys know how we rocking as far as that 1K is concerned. So just turn y'all boys' post notifications on to be notified for that shit, you know what I'm saying? And I appreciate y'all, you know what I'm saying? I appreciate y'all boys for it. But I'm really going to let y'all boys know within that video. You know what I mean? So turn y'all boys' post notifications on to be notified for that video, man. And let's get it, bro. Gang.